aware of any compulsive organizing rituals.
Blue, pencil, green, black.
Hello and welcome!
Bienvenida!
Katanga!
Willkommen!
Welcome! This here is Topical Fruit, the show where we get our teeth into the ripest contemporary issues. I am GOC, your host. To some, I am an eccentric, flamboyant, erudite, dashing motormouth.
No!
To others, I am simply a posh, wordy bellend.
Hey.
Quiet at the back!
Do excuse that, ladies and gentlemen. It was we OC, my mischief-making brother, sinful kinsman, not me.
He does like to disrupt my didactica every now and then.
Now, so far, the reaction to our show can be summed up with a look from quizzical Lara. We've had the usual treatment from the silent guy, and the actual grocers, largely ambivalent. Never mind!
We shall plough our furrow, and furrow our brows, and follow with bows.
If you've got it, flaunt it. If they've got it, flout it.
If you've got a furrow, then bally well plough it!
The second portion of our show is about health. A jumbo topical fruit indeed, one rarely out of the fruit bowl at the table of debate, and no trifling matter.
Trifle!
Be it the increasing importance placed on mental health, or the to and fro of scientific research saying that drinking a pint of wine is or isn't good for you. Me? I'm in rude health and healthy rudeness. How else do I be doing this in 37 years, 3 months, 2 hours and 44 minutes?
So why not pluck a topical fruit and get your portion of fresh debate?
Hey, Mr. Tangerine Man, play a song for us!
I'm not sleepy.
So, health. They say that life and death, heaven and hell, are all part of the same journey. But if that's the case, what's purgatory? Little chef? Yes, if you've got your health, that's all that really matters. But, personally speaking, no day of mine is complete without an iced bun. Some people are health conscious, some people are not.
Humans are supposed to eat a balanced diet.
If not, you're a slob.
It's more complicated than that. I'm too busy working, partying, shape-shifting. Let someone else dabble with the fruit salad. I'll dice with death by chocolate. But I'll have it with reincarnation milk, just in case. I'd be reborn as a cream horn.
What gets on my pecs is fitness tourism. Kids come in the gym, they want to look like The Rock. But they want to do it in 6 weeks.
It doesn't happen overnight.
They blitz it for a month, and if you're still bigger than them, you must be on steroids. I'm from the old school, where it's hard and long.
To get to the core of this plentiful subject, let's sling it out to a bumper crop of top bananas.
First up is a man who knows his stuff and who advises us here at Top Through HQ, John Limer. Let me do what I want.
So scandalous. Do you know my name? You know my name. John Limer. Call me John. I've got lime scales. Limer purveys limes and advice pertaining to limes and other fruit-based products. The world at large and chapter at small. Limer, shag, Cheryl, scandal. The deed was done on a nuptial noontide. Double scandal. Limer spies a scandal. Limer gets involved. On the subject of health, I go back to scandal 43. Me and Mo in the locker room. Limer gave him a magic fizz pill. Sparko. Fizz. He took the track. I was in the tunnel. And said, run, Farrah, run. Covered 10,000 meters in an implausible 2 minutes 30 seconds. Everyone was surprised. Apart from Limey. Meteor, shitstorm, buzz, feed from the Twitter commentary. Mo couldn't handle the limelight. He took the flak. I took the Carolyn. His career took a nosedive. He was a broken man. So he turned to the only person that could help. The one who started it all. John Limey. Cause my name's John Limer. What did Limer advise? He advised. Dram of this a day. Up your game, return the fame, and remember the name. Limer. Mo went on to greatness in London, Bali, Rio. Profits doubled. Nicely learned.
So, for a healthy balanced lifestyle, eat a lime a day.
To stop scurvy holding sway.
To make any woman lay.
And win free tickets to James Bay.
And who are you going to buy from?
Limer. Well, gotta go. Limer's got a job on. And when Limer's got a job on, everyone knows Limer can do jobs. Before that, Tweety, it's time for the sucker punch. Piss.
Cheers, John! Succulent and not truculent.
A hard game to play, balancing ambition with legal nutrition.
Especially in the modern age.
What's my idea of a modern lifestyle?
You've got to be nourished.
Like eat half a chicken, half a broccoli, every half hour.
You've got to be active. Like swim from Dublin to Cuba.
You've got to be clean. And I mean so clean that you could eat dinner from my ass, you know what I mean?
And ideally, you've got to be sponsored.
Now, onto another fine specimen. Sharp, sweet, full of vital vitamins. Our lass, Jules.
Health? Don't go there. But you did, so I'll come with. NHS cuts. Overseas aid. Doritos in the cinema.
Bring your own cucumber sandwiches.
Doritos taste good to you, but to us, it sounds like a pig snaffling on peanuts. My number one rule? Be safe, you dicks. If you're cooking pasta, don't leave the hob on and then go on holiday to Mallorca. If you're going skydiving, don't forget your parachute and then claim it's alright because you're aiming for a bouncy castle, you pillock. If you're going sunbathing, don't slather on goose fat to tan faster. Follow rules and take precautions.
If you're out of condoms and you can't actually make a replacement out of bubble wrap, that's fine.
Just watch out for traffic.
Keep clean.
And wear clothes. And the rest will click into place. Including us.
Zing-a-dings from Jules. To err on the side of caution or to throw caution to the winds. Technology's improved many areas of life, but is it all it's cracked up to be?
We are now smarter because of technology. End of. Starting with the smartphone, we can just do more at once. Check emails, chat to mates, home wanker form, the iPad, the iWatch. I'm talking to you now on the iKettle. It makes the tea and there's a side screen you can Skype on. Trouble is, I can't figure out how to boil the water. I'll Google it.
Now, the other end of the branch, we go to a wild, totally GM-free berry. Bishop!
Good day, and welcome to Outback with Bishop. With me, Outback. No, Bishop! The bush is an unforgiving, seductive, dry bosom. Rule number two, always carry fluids. My tipple of choice is, of course, Foster's. Thank you, Sheila.
My name's Layla!
Whatever. So, health. You gotta look after yourself in the wild, or you'll end up 6 feet down under. My daddy always says,
listen, son. Never mind a gubber spidey or electric wallaby. Go out at the wrong time of day in your dingo tucker. Near noon, you'll be fried like a shrimp on the barbie. And near night, you'll be frozen like a shrimp in the icebox. You can check the time on your phone these days. Now that is space age. You need to go out when the clock strikes seven. The owl hoots in the bush, and the witch chants her rites.
Right, that's when the witch hoots, the clock chants, and the owl strikes.
Thereabouts. Space age.
Fat income, daddy-o. Amongst the endless sand, snakes, spiders, and sand, survival skills are vital. Take supplies.
Cover your tracks.
Watch out for deadly critters.
And know how to extract the nourishing gristle out of a nipple ant. Failing that, you can use the Malula Bar Belly Cook Fun Pellet. And with love. Buy one, get none free at your local Bishop Grub Hut. Not to be confused with the Wow Wow Shit Quick Gastro Capsule. And with hate. Simply pop in the gob, swallow, and be amazed at how this goes into a full meal inside your skip.
Sheila!
My name's Layla!
Whatever!
Swish bish! A lecture with the amber nectar. Our environs plays a big part in our health, and adapting our needs to it is crucial, as is caring for our environs in turn.
Hearken to me.
We are eco-warriors.
To save Mama Gaia,
we must all start eating free-range local organum.
It's good for your bums and tums.
Yes. Regular dumpers we are.
And humpers in the hemp nest.
You make my legs quiver.
Not now, Mugwort. Keep your veg in the crisper.
Mugwort, you sexual bitch! Can
actually give us some niblets, easy. I've only eaten twigs for 2 weeks.
For some, the state of the world is their main concern. For others, the state of their do.
It's healthy to look good, and I look good because I'm healthy and because I'm worth it. Everything about me is great. From my proper canny do to my rosy rear. Your new fella proper thinks so too.
Call me Jan.
Let's hope the journos don't find out. I mean, I wouldn't want all that attention. Press coverage and money. Am I worth it? I'm worth it.
And now we move on to Q&A, our interview segment, in which I shall be conversing with Charlie Blow, famous rock star, narcotics advocate, and renowned Lothario. On we go! So, Charlie Blow, how do I find you today?
I'm scared.
Why is that?
This camera, man, freaking me out.
A lens of judgment.
Well, if needs be, we can make our equipment less visible.
Dirty.
That wasn't dirty.
You win.
This is peculiar.
You're peculiar.
To focus on the matter in hand.
Dirty.
So, Charlie Blow, what would you say is the key to a healthy, happy life?
Sex, drugs, rock and roll.
Haha, the classic. In that precise order.
It stops mattering after a while, mate. As long as they're all together, I'm happy as Larry.
Just how content is Lawrence?
Oh, fucking ecstatic.
I must ask, why do you wear sunglasses indoors?
Protection, mate. Fucking done so much shit over the years. Sunlight, eyes, freaky as fuck.
Well, I'm afraid that so we may forge the connection required for this interview, you must remove them.
You've asked for it.
You are the former lead singer of UK rock band The Massive Boulders, with seminal global hits such as Sexual Detonation, Novocaine Hurricane, and Saluting Major Tom. Having played mammoth world tours to packed arenas in New York, Madrid, London, and Slough, having slept with a reported 2 million women, and a man who allegedly gets through 5 bottles of Jim Beam a day. Now, some would say that it's frankly a miracle you're still alive. Your response?
Some people are built for it, fella. Some people are born to be accountants, crunch numbers. That's what they do. I crunch riffs.
And pills?
It's the lifestyle, mate.
I'm gonna have the constitution.
I'm scared.
Of what?
Cameraman. This was serious ganja last night and I'm fucking still spinning out.
Can't you take the kit away? Without the camera, this wouldn't be an interview, Mr. Blow. It would simply be a very formal, unseen, largely redundant conversation.
You win.
I win what?
Dunno.
A cuddly toy?
You're a cuddly toy.
So I'd win myself?
I don't know. You're the law.
I'm not, you know.
You win.
I'm lost.
I'm scared.
Pressing on. Now, some people would say that your lifestyle is in fact counteractive to a healthy and happy life, Mr. Blow. They would say that exercise, a balanced diet, and education are the keys to a good life.
I've never fucking been sucked up by an elephant.
Probably not. Talking of sexual adventures, it says in your new autobiography, Blow by Blow, that you once knobbed the Queen.
Twice. Liz loved it. Said I had great stamina.
I see. So, you'd say, to be happy in life, you need some hedonism.
Dunno. What is it?
What you do.
Yeah, do what I do. Music's important too, man. You gotta have expression, spontaneity, creative chaos. Freedom is fulfillment. Vice versa. Bang out with tunes, fuck all the girls, crabs.
You're saying without art, we'd all be boring farts.
Dirty.
Yes, that was actually dirty.
Sorry, quick call to my mate. Phil? You alright, Phil? Phil? Go, mate. You fucking fed the tiger yet, man? Good guy. Phil? Fucking get on the blows of them moving men. I need that sex dungeon erect ASAP.
Phil?
Yeah, we'll be there. We'll love it. Do that, Phil. Phil?
Carry on, G-Spot.
Your moving house?
She's got a new place in Surrey. 1,000 bedrooms. 104 wives.
Are you a Mormon?
Ah, just too many women, man. They don't call me Count Cunnilingus for nothing.
Why do they call you that?
Love a good old lick, mate.
Everyone needs a hobby. It seems that the rock and roll lifestyle is certainly not without its benefits. However, you recently split acrimoniously from the rest of the massive boulders to forge a solo career. What happened?
I couldn't handle my massive, paranoid, megalomaniacal ego.
Nah! I see. Very candid for a rock star. I hear you are providing the soundtrack to new exploitation flick, Escape from Planet Spunk, and bringing out a new album entitled Ballads of the Monkey Minister.
Yeah, single's called E.T. Don't Beep.
Yep.
Finest work yet. You know, sing-along chorus. Kids will love it. Easy down, beep.
Well, we awaited with bated breath.
Dirty.
You're inserting these innuendos yourself.
Dirtier.
You're just thrusting your own filth into random areas of the conversation.
Dirtfest.
It's childish.
You're a childish.
I'm not. I'm older than you.
I win.
The lowdown from Blowtown. Some folks favour fruit of the fermented or hallucinogenic variety.
For some, that is anathema.
But others can't get enough of the latest exotic delight on the market.
Do you know how I stay so cool?
Energetic.
Full of life.
Vacuum.
You like Coke?
But
you need to sleep and be fresh in the morning.
The vacuum has it.
Coke.
Valium.
Combined.
With a twist of Viagra.
To keep your cock working.
Don't worry, I'll get you some.
Now, where am I?
Who am I?
And who the fuck are you?
There's even word of a line of spacey new potatoes out there. True spud. Alexander Skarsgård ain't best pleased. Now it's time for the man who's so salt of the earth he could catch sulfate poisoning off him, our fruit fool, Ted.
Really stupid.
Yeah, she actually had some...
Oh, hello. Welcome to TED Talks with talking from me, Ted. So, health. Living a healthy lifestyle. Eat, sleep, rut. And some beef. Afters. Couple of months back, had a few problems down in me orchard. Me apples were a bit rotten. Bit too much scrimping. So I went and saw old Dark Nettle.
Take two of these, my lovely. Take two of these!
Next thing I bloody know, I found myself on the moor. At night. Naked. Fully wooded. With only me ginsters for warmth. Then I saw it. 20 acres. Glowing. With one littlest teat. Double teacup. The breast of Bodmin.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
I leapt at it, falling into a deep sleep. Wife found me the next day. Wasn't too happy, though. Never had any problems in the bedroom with me Granny Smith since.
Handsome!
Don't stop me going for a repeat visit, though. Thirsty.
I've come to talk with you again.
So that was Ted, with more of his sage and onion advice. He focuses on physical health, whereas I put import on intellectual health. E.g. tips, I walked out with a girl once, Mildred Downey her name was, and we are both members of a proper punctuation promotion club. Up the bracket, people used to call us the syntax inspectors, and many a long afternoon we'd spend comparing the fineries and vagaries of a colon and a semicolon with peppermint and comfrey tea in hand. Great days. It ended when I started drinking coffee. Then she started walking out with one Herbert Cobb. Penis.
No, because I shagged her.
What?
I shagged her.
Just you come here and say that to my face, young man!
I shagged her.
She wanted the real man. A bit of action. Not just talking about words and shit for hours and hours. Like you and the other twin.
What happened to Herb?
Killed him. Then millionaire by a mic calling the cub. Lucky break.
Ah, well. We'll always have Casablanca.
You must remember this.
I raise her to the ground.
You and whose army?
The Greeks.
Cerebral ability is what you need, young fella Milano! Without great thinkers, we never would have reached civilization.
Without great fighters, we would have been dead by barbarians a long time ago. Martial prowess is what you need.
Women want brains!
Women want brawn!
What are you doing in this neck of the woods anyway?
Severing the head.
Of whom?
A common enemy.
Which is?
There was a weirdo lurking outside your place last night. Saw him off. I always keep watch.
Yeah, I thought I heard strange noises. The question is who?
And why?
Doesn't matter now. He's in bits.
Then never mind!
Hello? How you doing, Teddy boy? Long time no chinwag.
Handsome lad!
How's the missus?
Moist.
As you like it.
Aye!
We need to settle this, kinsman. I say the pen is mightier than the sword.
That's ridiculous! Total bullshit! Can't be done! If you tried going up against a sword with a pen, you'd be cleaved from bottom to bottom. The sword is always mightier.
Fuck it then. I've got a show to run here. Be off with you.
No.
How about one of these for your troubles? Thought it might tickle your French.
Fancy.
We don't have that many differences.
Some people. I have a question on my lord of the pasties.
Aye.
You get?
Aye.
Watch me whip. Watch me nae-nae. Now watch me whip, whip. Watch me nae-nae. Now watch me whip. Watch me nae-nae. Then watch me whip, whip. Watch me nae-nae.
Right, it's a scripty that bangs us some more about reading and vocab and all that swill.
But fuck that!
What you need to do, stay physically fit, shag freely, and keep moving. And, pint of wine, on the house. Daily.
Ah, vintage.
Have a joyful feeling. I'm off.
Right on the melon.
How crass my younger brother is. Always making my plans pear-shaped. Pressing on! Now we have some tinned fruit. In the form of our handyman and free incarnation of Schwarzenegger, your maker.
Your maker! You have met your maker! Lager! Showtime!
Information upload. I was sent to this planet, butt and bollock, by my maker, John Connor, to defend him from the attacks of the T-1000 and Christina Logan. Now that my mission has been successful and he has grown into the almighty Bale Clark, I can retire to Lager. Protect the weak and keeping my buff bod buff. This is Humping Iron. I will be telling you what's beef and what's bot. But to do this, I have called upon one man.
Hello, asshole.
Chill out, dickwad! I have no beef anymore!
Yes, agreed. You are like old weed now.
No! Still beef!
Bullshit. Loken is mine.
I have no time for Loken anymore! T3 was so 2003. I have Amelia Clark now. Genesis. Momoa didn't have the beef in Thrones.
He was no Conan.
What a weed. Let us chat the weeds.
No problemo.
Weed analysis. Brody.
Weed Bowen.
Weed Kevin Peter Hall. Freddy.
Weed. Willis.
Weed. Stallone.
Weed. Clooney.
Mega Weed. Malik.
Weed. Dance.
Weed. Ferrigno.
Green Weed. Earl Jones.
Darth Weed. Lady Jones.
Weed. Your maker. What a verbal weed. Ha. Ha ha.
Bullshit!
You have void rage. Cool your boots.
I am beef! From training, diet, and Conan!
In your dreams.
I am the real deal.
Beef.
Only one way to settle this. Olympiad! Wingman choice.
Only one man for the job.
Shocking.
Ha! You have chosen poorly. I choose the son of the damned. The muscles from Brussels. J.C.V.D.
John Lord Band.
Come for me, baby.
Where is the dam?
I trapped him in his ass palace.
Ah! Ah! You have lost this.
Hey, Franzo.
John Connor Lima.
Call me John.
John Connor Lima?
John Lima keeps score. And everyone knows when John Lima keeps score, the score will be settled.
Let's do this.
Lime!
This is an iron.
Come for me, baby!
lightly. Sorry, Franzo. Mighty is his pith.
Ha ha ha! Hasta la vista, baby! Right! Time to do more weights and get to the chopper! I'll be back.
Meet your maker.
Checking your flow, yo. Hustling for muscle is worth the bustle, but we can't forget the brain and its pains. How to stay sane.
When it comes to mental health, the NHS just use us as guinea pigs for new treatments. They should prioritise therapy. God forbid we should talk about our feelings. Depression, a yo-yo, bipolar, glacier mint, schizophrenia, earplugs. It's just to make profits for the multinationals. Let's put these company CEOs on the wheel. See how they like it.
Right, let's juice this jambalaya.
That's nice, you can have it the next day though.
Pulp Friction.
Hmm. What seems to be the overall flavour of this topical fruit is moderation. Have your fun, have a bun, but know your quotas. Look after your bod and your bonce, and all will be mint. Ultimately, the choice is that of the individual, but I'd say everything in moderation, including moderation. And with that, dear fruit tubers, ciao for now.
Let's keep the moon.